You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
For the community, by the community.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success, that is success at work and in life. The Ember months have begun. It's September. Can you believe it? It's the end of 2010, almost. I mean, 2010 is winding up, and then if you're like me, you're probably asking yourself, where am I? And where are my relationships? Yes, that's what I said. Where are you? Where are you in comparison to the goals that you set for yourself at the beginning of 2010? And where are things on the home front, in your personal life? You know, these have been the questions that I've been pondering upon over the last 2 months. Because, you know, my philosophy is that true success is success at work and in life. If you are successful in only one aspect of your life, maybe professionally, and then your personal life is in a chaotic, at the end of the day, your personal life that's chaotic is going to come and haunt your professional life. I mean, you all know recently that Tiger Woods got divorced, and I'm not here to condemn him. I actually feel sorry for him. But that's just a classic example of what happens when we hone our skills professionally or in one aspect of our lives and neglect our personal lives. What happens is that ultimately that area of that's been neglected comes to haunt our personal life and in, our professional life, interfere with it, and at the end of the day, we'll probably end up destroying it. So that's what we've been doing over the summer. I asked viewers, you know, via my e-newsletter. And so that means that if you're yet to connect to me with me on the internet, either via email, via Facebook, Twitter, or LinkedIn, please do so immediately, because you'll be missing out on a lot of programs and, you know, upcoming things and, you know, activities that I share over the summer when we're airing reruns of Inspired Success. So, and you can, you know, you can sign up for my e-newsletter. You can connect with me online. If you go to www.royalproclamations.com, you can sign up for my e-newsletter there. And of course, like I said, all the social networking sites, you know, I'm on there. Just search for Princess Bola Adelani. So anyway, via my e-newsletter over the summer in July and August, I was asking, you know, viewers to join me in reflecting on life, in reflecting on work, and in reflecting on their relationships. And so today we're going to be sharing the results of my own reflection and the power of reflection. The power of reflection, why it is so important for us to take time, you know, away, to take time to retreat and reflect and assess and evaluate where we are, where we're going, and how we plan to get there. And so that's what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be reflecting on life, on work, and on relationships. And I'm going to be sharing my results of my reflection, and I'm going to be sharing on the power of reflection. The power of reflection. What does it mean to reflect? To reflect really means to ponder, you know, to critically assess, to evaluate, to measure, to meditate, to give deep thought to something, okay? And so that's what reflection is all about. And what is the power of reflection? Why is it good for us to spend time reflecting? One of the powers or advantages of reflection is that reflection helps us to focus. It's so important to focus, because without directing our energy and focusing on our goals, there is no way that we're going to achieve them. So, you know, reflection helps us to focus. Reflection also helps us to eliminate distractions and wastes. Okay, so when you're focused, you now be able to kind of eliminate the things or the relationships or the things that are in your life that are not productive. So that's another power of reflection. Also, when we reflect, you know, it helps to enhance creative thinking. So when you take time to reflect, you enhance your creative thinking, and your creative energy flows and your creativity flows. So you're better able to strategize and to plan in terms of accomplishing your goals, in terms of reaching your goals. Okay, so those are some of the powers of reflection. And then reflection also calms our soul. It calms our minds, helps us to relieve ourselves of some stress, because now, you know, our mind is calmer and, you know, we are able to focus and we're meditating, and basically it just calms and relieves us of stress. So it's really a great and great powerful exercise. Now, I'm talking about positive reflection, because we could be reflecting and we could be reflecting negatively. Some of us reflect, and at the end of the day, we reflect over our mistakes and the feelings that come up, embarrassment or guilt or condemnation or self-loathe, you know, or anger or whatever. I'm not talking about that kind of reflection. That's negative reflection. That is unproductive reflection. But I'm talking about the kind of reflection whereby you're evaluating, you're assessing, you know, you're focusing, you're re-strategizing, and you're coming up with new plans and a map and a strategy to help you to reach your goals and to propel you forward. Okay, so that's the kind of reflection I'm talking about, and that's the power of positive reflection. And now, what are some of the steps that you can take, you know, to have productive and positive reflection? You know, because it's so powerful, because at the end of the day, if you're trying to get to your goals or trying to reach your dreams, you know, or improve a relationship or bring change into your life, you have to take that time to reflect. And what are the steps? How do you do it? I know in this very crazy world that we live in, where we never have enough time, with, or so we think, you know, we actually have more time than we realize, and we just have to, it's a question of our values, you know, it's what you value. You make time for what you value. And I want you to really understand that how powerful reflection is, because, you know, hopefully it would help you to really value it and take time to start practicing reflection. So one of the ways to practice reflection is, first of all, committing the time. You know, out of your busy schedule, look for that time. And it doesn't have to be a whole lot of time. You know, I am self-employed, so I manage my own schedule. Some of us don't have that privilege. But it could be a few hours on a Saturday morning. It could be a few hours late at night. It could be any time, but some time that you will devote, that you have committed to go and spend to reflect and meditate. And the next thing that you want to do is to find a quiet place. just look for a very quiet location where you actually want to do it, okay? And, you know, it could be in your house, it could be somewhere in your apartment, it could be in your bedroom, but just look for a very tranquil place. You can go to the park, you can go to the beach, you know, whatever works for you. But look for a tranquil place and then go there with an objective. Go there with your notepad, with the writing, your journal, get ready to write and go with an objective. What is it that you're really focused on? What is the objective of your reflection? What area of your life are you reflecting or focused on? Okay. And then begin to write your thoughts and journal them down and assess and measure where you are and come up with a plan and a strategy and commit to implementing that plan. So that is what the power of reflection, and those are the steps to reflection, okay? Because like I said, you know, I spent the summer, July and August, basically, you know, that's one of the perks of really being self-employed, because I really try and devote that time really to being a mother, which is one of the most important jobs that I could have, as well as also spending it to reflect on my life, on my relationship, and on my work, you know? And so we did that. And then I came up with some results. Voila. And I said to myself, hey, the power of the reflection is that you now get the power to change. Reflection will bring the strategy for change and for growth. I want to say that again. Reflection releases the power for strategy and for growth. Okay, reflection releases the power for strategy and for growth. I want you to state that again. Reflection releases the power for strategy and for growth. And I know you want to grow, and I know you want to finish 2010 strong. Okay, so do I. And I believe that you will finish 2010 strong. So, you know, I took time. I practiced what I preach. I'm sure you know that. So I took time, like I asked you to take time to reflect. And I began to reflect on my work. I began to reflect on my personal relationships. And I'm like, oh my goodness, it needs a total overhaul. You know, my work as well as my personal relationships needs a makeover. I'm going to start with the results of my reflection on my work. After I reflected on my work, on my goals, on my mission of empowering people, I came up with a plan that I really needed to revamp my website totally, because that is one of the ways in which I connect with my people, with my viewers and my audience. And so I'm revamping my website. I'm making it more interactive. I'm making it more resourceful, and I'm making it more informational. Interactive in the sense that now you can go to my website, royalproclamations.com, in a few weeks when it will be ready, and you can actually leave a message for me on my message board. You can leave comments about the show or about any other thing. You can ask me questions. We can actually now begin to have a conversation, an ongoing conversation. Isn't that just great? You know, because I think that way it's better allowing me to better able to reach my mission, which is really empowering people and transforming lives. Okay, so that's one of the things, new features my website is going to have. It's going to be more resourceful because I'm going to be bringing a lot more products and links and other website and resources to you, including free ones. And, you know, so that's just great. That will help you develop you in all areas of your life. And then it's going to be more informational, apart from information and helping you stay in the loop as to the offerings and the programs that I have upcoming. It would also be able to, you also be able to learn about programs in the community and other events and all that that are really more very empowering. So that's kind of what I came up with after. I also came up with this plan to start having an ongoing conversation via television. So with you, my viewers. And so beginning in October next month, we're going to actually be having call-in and live shows. Isn't that just so exciting? Whereby you and I can have a conversation. You can actually call in to the show, ask me questions, give me your feedback, and we can talk about all spheres of life. And so that was one of the plans that came as a result of my reflection, that I'm going to be doing that, you know, whether on a quarterly basis, you know, maybe biannually, but once in a while, I'll be actually having that live shows and call-in shows. And so, you know, these are some of the exciting things that came as a result of really reflecting. And that is how it works in your own personal life too. You know, when you take time to reflect, you'll come up with all these creative ways, this strategy for growth, for improvement, for change. You know, you'll come up with ways in which you can make your career better, which in which you maybe you would reflect and you think it's time for a new job. Maybe I need to shift my focus. Maybe I need to eliminate certain things from my life, you know, that is not making me productive or fruitful, you know. So that's a great thing about reflection. And those are some of the exciting things that came up as a result of my own reflection. Also, as far as relationship concerns, oh my goodness. You know, as I was reflecting on my own personal relationship, I was just reflecting also on relationships in general. And it's like there's an epidemic, you know, out there as far as relationships are concerned. You know, what's going on? The statistics are staggering. They're frightening. Do you know that 60% of all first-time marriages end up in divorce? That means 6 out of 10. We cannot seem to stay together. You know, we cannot seem to, you know, work it out. I don't know, you know, with the opposite sex. I don't know why. And yet, I find that 80 to 90% of single men and women want to be in a relationship. Isn't that funny? So those who are single want to be in a relationship. They want to be entangled with somebody. And those who are married want to untangle and want to get out of the relationship. And so after reflecting on this, reflecting on my own personal relationship, looking at where I was emotionally, you know, looking at whether my relationship was feeding me and whether I was going in the direction that I really would like it to go, I decided that it was time for a relationship makeover show. It was time for me to really get back into this conversation about the opposite sex. What is love? You know, why can't men and women seem to get along? Why can't we stay married? You know, what are the issues? Are we so totally different from one another? Or is there more that, you know, unites us, or do we complement one another? I want you to refer you to my June broadcast. If you missed that, you want to go and take a look at it again. It was on the one thing that men want women to know about men. And so, you know, I decided from my reflection that it was time to continue that conversation and take that conversation to the next level and begin to talk about, you know, what are the needs that women have? And what are the needs that men have? What is love? Have we got this concept of love, you know, out of whack, out of balance? You know, do we have this idealistic a view of love? What really is love? You know, does true love exist? I was wondering, you know, or is it a myth? You know, and what is it that we're looking for in relationships? And how can we improve those relationships? So, you know, I came up with a very exciting show for next month. And it's titled Man to Woman Express. Okay, you know, and, you know, the relationship empowerment show. And I'm going to be bringing in guests and, you know, viewers like yourself can come on. I really, really would like to hear from you. I want to bring in a diverse panel of men, women, and youth. And we want to really talk about love, and we want to talk about relationships, and we want to talk about improving relationships. Because like I said at the beginning of the show, if we can get our relationships right, our personal lives right, we can't get it in order, you know, then at the end of the day, it's going to come and, you know, destroy whatever progress or success we've attained in other areas of our lives, you know. So it's about having this holistic approach and philosophy to life where nothing is missing, nothing is broken. And that's where I am, the total success coach, where it's about the total being, the total person, the whole person, you know, that, and it's about all spheres and all dimensions of life, where your emotional, your spiritual, your health, and everything has to be in harmony and in balance for you to be truly successful. So I really want to encourage you, if you want to come on the show, on the broadcast next month, please, I really, really encourage you to contact me. The information, my contact information is on the screen right now. You can call me. You can email me at info@royalproclamations.com. You can visit my website and fill in the contact form. And you can even call the WHCTV, which is West Hartford Community Television Station, and they would, you know, just pass on the information to me. Just tell me you want to come on the show, the Man to Woman Express, and the relationship, you know, makeover broadcast in October is going to be taped in September 29th. At 7 p.m. at the West Hartford Community Television Studio in the Town Hall in West Hartford. Okay, so make a note of that. If you cannot come onto the show, you can also email me your questions. You can email your questions ahead of time, or you can call me with your questions ahead of time. I really, really want you to be a part of the conversation. And so that's all I basically have for you for today. We've been reflecting on life, we've been reflecting on work, and we've been reflecting on relationships. And I've told you how so very important it is to take time to reflect, take time to retreat, take time to re-strategize, take time to plan, you know, and evaluate and measure where are you vis-a-vis your goals, and what steps could you be taking to bring you closer to your goals, to make sure that you finish 2010 strong? What about your relationships? How are things on the home front? What kind of improvements or changes can you make? Even if you're single, you know, and you're looking for love, you know, and, you know, you've probably been burnt once before. You don't want to make the same mistakes. So, you know, what are the principles? How do I find true love? Does it exist? Is it in my mind? You know, these are the kind of things I want you to reflect on and come up with a plan so that when you go into your next relationship, you know, it's better than the previous one, okay? So really take that time to do it, to practice reflection. It's a really, really therapeutic exercise, very powerful exercise for the soul, for the spirit, and for the mind. And I want to remind you to connect with me. I'm on Facebook, Princess Bola Adelani. I'm on LinkedIn, Princess Bola Adelani. I'm on Twitter, Princess Bola Adelani. And I'm on my website via email at my website, www.royalproclamations.com. I'm on email. I mean, just stay connected. Let's stay in touch. Let's stay in contact. And let's keep the conversation and the dialogue going. I have some amazing programs that I've planned just for you, just for you, just for you, just to empower you, just to inspire you, just to motivate you to reach your fullest potential, you know. And one of them is coming up on Saturday, November 6th, 2010, is the first annual Total Woman Conference for girls and young women. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited about this program, about this conference. Okay, I'm doing it in partnership with St. Joseph's College. You know, it's for the Generation Y, girls and young women aged 12 to 35. I mean, isn't that a demographic that we really need to reach and inspire and empower? I'm sure you know someone within that generation, in that age group, and that you could invite, that you could bring, that you could encourage to attend this program. It's on Saturday, November 6th at St. Joseph's College campus in West Hartford, Connecticut. More information about this program, about other coaching, training, and speaking programs that I have are available on my website, www.royalproclamations.com. It's been great reconnecting with you after the summer break, and it's great. I want to welcome you back to school for all my back to school viewers, and for those of you who are like me, who are self-employed, whose fiscal year runs really from September to June. When the kids are back in school, then you're back to some serious kind of focused work. I also want to welcome you back to work and wish you all life success for this new semester and this new academic year. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Hey, come on, life's too short. Put a smile on that face, okay? Keep believing, keep networking, keep learning, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next month as we're going to be talking about man to woman express and the whole relationship makeover stuff. I will see you next month. Make sure you tell a friend and you tune in. God bless you. Bye-bye.